WBZ and FindMassMoney.com have a clue for you. Unclaimed money can take the form of stocks, bonds, or one of these funds, also called the unit trust.
Did you know that Massachusetts has 14 million accounts equaling $2.4 billion in unclaimed money, stocks, insurance claims, and more? Log on to FindMassMoney.com to search for your name and see if you have unclaimed money waiting for you.
The correct response? What is a mutual fund? Watch Jeopardy! Weeknights at 7:30 on WBZ.
Begins tonight at disease, Louisa Mora, she's live in the Missouri, where the plane, Louisa, is still sticking out from that rooftop.
Well, David, the building is all boarded up now, but that plane, as you said, is still inside, lodged in two different condos, and that's where it will stay until the NTSB and FAA take a good look at what happened here. A shark now covers the gaping hole where a single engine homeless plane violently landed Tuesday. I was earlier neighbors left in terror as the sonic dropped out of the sky, crushing the building at Pride Cross Condominium. Former Newbury Port Mayor and pilot Al Lavender was killed by the impact. Crews say he was the only person on board the plane, which was trying to land at Lawrence Airport when something went horribly wrong.
The plane crashed and went up the fuel, and then, explosion, collapse, definitely unsafe up there with the rafters. It's not breaking the rafters. So.
I was in the house, and I heard an enormous sound. It sounded like something exploded.
25 people were inside the building and rushed to get out. This picture showing the destruction left inside Mike Pagliarone's condo.
I'm walking back. This isn't the guy that I wasn't there, you know. I know I usually work on those eyes anyway, but, you know, I couldn't do anything today.
Another man was in the condo right next door.
All of a sudden, there was a big crash and boom. The whole building shook. We looked out my back window there, and all I could see was insulation falling off the roof.
All of the residents were able to escape unharmed, but they realized it was close. Again, the NTSB and FAA will be here investigating tomorrow. 34 different people were displaced from this building. They're now being assisted by the Red Cross. Live in the studio, Louisa Mora, WBZ News.
And we did some digging on the type of plane that crashed here and learned it does have some problems. The IC, Chelsea, and DACA spoke to the former member of the New York City Police Department's aviation unit, and he told us the sonic aircraft has been known to have problems with overheating. Again, no official cause yet for the crash.
But tonight we are learning more about the pilot, Al Lavender. His friend said he spent years building his plane, and he loves to fly. WBZ Tim Smith picked up our live coverage now in Newbury Port. Jim?
He said there was much sadness tonight here at Newbury Port City Hall, and indeed throughout the entire community. Al Lavender was a former mayor who touched many lives.
He was a very caring individual.
Al Lavender was many things. An avid pilot, a former mayor and city councilor. But close friends remember the man himself, always a smile, full of life. Another former councilor and neighbor still can't believe it.
We were very close. Every time he got to speed, he'd stop and talk at me, or I'd give him my card, he'd go talk. He got talking powerful. And he told me when he was building a plane, he built it himself. He's an engineer.
Alan Lavender certainly had a passion for flying. The plane he built was his pride and joy, and while building it, he made sure everything was perfect. He passed an FAA inspection. Bob DeMeo was his technical advisor.
He said, "We should come over and take a look at it." So I did, and like I said, it looked sound. It looked like he had done a nice job with the airplane. And I said, I think it's ready.
Now at City Hall, the flag is at half staff as the community honors a man who was such a big part of Newburyport. The current mayor just spoke with him on Monday.
Everyone who knew him enjoyed working with him. He had a kind and gentle spirit, very even feel, easy smile, easy to laugh.
And back there live in Newburyport tonight, a close friend tells me that Al Lavender was 73 years old. The mayor says that Newburyport officials will soon be making plans to honor him in a memorial at a later date. Live in Newburyport, Jim Smith, WBZ News.
Jim, thank you. Incredibly, it is not the first time a small plane hit the complex. In 1999, a plane had just taken off from Lawrence Airport when it lost power and crashed just feet from the condo building. Three adults on board were critically hurt, but 4-year-old Aaron Cadet suffered only minor injuries. Now 22 years old, he told me tonight that his crash was a difficult moment.
I couldn't believe it. I was, literally coming off the same spot. My plane didn't couldn't hit the building. I didn't do it 3 feet away from me. What a coincidence.
Cadet told me his
protected him in that crash, which is why he wasn't badly injured tonight, because the Sox's condolences go out to the pilot family in today's crash. And Steve worked around the clock to secure the scene in the sand. Stay with WBZ, both on the air and online, to continue coverage of this accident. David?
We said tonight a storm watch weather alert, severe storm, striking in the Midwest right now. Tornado threats from Chicago to Iowa, and that system is headed our way. But that's only part of the story. The other part is the warmth and a run at another record, possibly tomorrow, during the Eric here. And last week we hit 70. We're not going to quite get there, but we're going to get there.
Might still be in the territory again tomorrow. That's going to feel humid as we head to the cross to maybe we'll always be using the humid word. But here's a look at the radar tonight. You see all those storms running across the Midwest. We're going to track them almost like it's summertime. The ones in Michigan are going to come down across the Great Lakes and get to us tomorrow. Lots of reports of tornadoes and wind damage. Won't be quite as severe when it gets here, but we are going to be looking at that risk. We might even see a severe thunderstorm watch box issued in parts of New England tomorrow. The timeline, a few cloudy showers tomorrow morning, cloudy skies. I think our best chance for some downpour, some thunder, and some damaging wind gusts will be late morning to the early afternoon, eventually 10 o'clock to about 2 o'clock as they move across. Then we should get another round later on in the evening. I think that they, for the most part, are going to arrive after sunset. Also, tracking those temps way up into the 60s. Believe it or not, that's about tomorrow, 20 by Saturday. We'll take a look at that coming up in a few. David, for the forecast coming up, Eric, we'll see in a few minutes. We will track the storm threat through the night. The latest on the weather alert tomorrow morning starting at 4:30.
Breaking now at 11, a deadly accident in the parking lot at Trader Joe's in Akron. A driver in his 20s backed over a woman's shoulder. Tonight we learned the victim is in her 60s and she worked at the store. Police are now questioning the driver of the SUV who stopped immediately and so far he's not facing any charges. There is a shared sense of grief on Cape Cod tonight where a beloved teacher was murdered overnight and police say her husband killed her, stabbing her while their two young children were in the house. WBZ here in McDonald, it was in the Patriot neighborhood tonight where people knew something was wrong and called 911.
We actually watched something in the bus and talked about it. I didn't want to share it from anybody else.
Parents in Barnstable leading painful conversations with their kids after the brutal murder of a beloved teacher. Police found Molly Fratantonio stabbed to death inside her home on Southbrook Road overnight. Investigators believe her husband, Chris Fratantonio, killed her. Other two young children were also home.
Everything was just at home again.
36-year-old Fratantonio said nothing as he was arraigned in court for his wife's murder. As the school day wore on, students struggled with how something so bad could be done to someone so good.
So what is that stuff? Like somebody who just knows that? Something that? Because she would always have used my schoolwork.
Luke's mom asked her to be on camera, but said Mrs. Fratantonio didn't just praise kids for their grades. She also celebrated their kindness.
She's willing to help, and she wanted to keep just kind and loving, and she's so supportive. And she's just a great neighbor, great mom.
Grief counselors will be available to students and staff this week as they mourn the loss of a bright smile in the hallways and an educator who made kids believe in themselves.
Well, she said that I would be great. And I believe that. Fratantonio is being held without bail and he'll be back in court on March 27th. In Barnstable, Rue McDonald, WBZ News.
There was a powerful moment at tonight's Bruins game.
The team honoring first responders and their families, and a family of speaking Thomas Clardy took part in the pregame ceremony.
Clardy, you'll remember, was killed in a crash last year while he was on duty. His 4-year-old son Noah dropped the first puck.
We'll go ahead tonight, a bat attack outside a police station.
Next at 11, you will see the drastic measures officers had to take this man down.
Also, a big award for superstar Rihanna. But this wasn't about music. The top honor she received from Harvard.
Plus, getting back in the game, a baby seal released back into the wild. Thanks to some great teamwork and the Patriots champion.
WBZ and American Alarm have a clue for you. While developing a gas sensor, a Swiss physicist lit a cigarette and accidentally invented the first one of these safety devices. Speaking.
For your home security, you could depend on a nosy neighbor or the 24-hour security command center with 20-second response from American Alarm. It's better than a nosy neighbor. American Alarm, New England's trusted security company.
The correct response? What is a smoke detector? What's Jeffrey? Jeopardy! Weeknights at 7:30 on WBZ.
Rihanna star power lit up Harvard today. She's taking home an honor, not for her music.
Well, that's right. She is the Humanitarian of the Year. WBZ's Jen McLeod is live at Harvard Sports tonight, where she accepted that big award, Jen. And David, to call Rihanna a monster star kind of understates it. She sold more than 200 million records, but her visit to campus today, as you noted, wasn't about her music or her fashion.
So I made it to Harvard.
She had fun with it, as always, but Robin Fenty, far better known as mega music star Rihanna, didn't make it to Harvard with her voice. She made it with her heart.
Her presence is able to inspire so many people from all around the world to be who they are and appreciate where they come from.
And for Rihanna, that's Barbados, where she opened a state-of-the-art cancer diagnosis and treatment center in the name of her late grandmother, who taught her humility.
My grandmother always used to say, if you got a dollar, there's plenty to share.
Indeed, Rihanna was honored today as Harvard's Humanitarian of the Year for her charitable efforts, which began at age 18 with her Believe Foundation to help terminally ill kids.
I'm incredibly humbled by this, to be acknowledged at this magnitude for something that, in truth, I've never wanted credit for.
Her celebrity is certainly overwhelming. A polite kiss made the Harvard dean a bit dizzy. But way deeper, students told us that Rihanna had used her star power to make her healthcare and scholarship initiative global.
I think what Rihanna does is that she brings that discussion outside of America. She says, hey, let's look at what's happening in the rest of the world.
Her simple advice to students, start small.
And at BLF, our mission is to impact as many lives as possible. But it starts with just one. Just one.
And then, don't expect anything in return.
To me, that is a humanitarian.
It was a whirlwind campus visit for Rihanna, but she did get to spend a little bit of one-on-one time with students, urging them to help others and also to see themselves. Live at Harvard tonight, 10 o'clock, WBZ News.
I love seeing that.
That was awesome.
Right, and her words of wisdom were so profound, even though she was really young.
You know how you make the transition from Rihanna to Rihanna?
Start?
No, you change. Umbrella, Ella, Ella.
Here
tomorrow.
There you go.
Yeah, I'll be a fitting song for tomorrow. We will be meeting your Umbrella, Ella, tomorrow outside. And we're also going to talk about our light jackets because it's going to be another really warm day, and especially we've had very warm weather. Meteorological winter is December, January, February, and today it would be fifth warmest on record in Boston after the second warmest last winter. And we have been on a run in the last 11 days. We had the cold, we had the snow. It is a distant memory at this point. In fact, the month will end up well above average for snowfall. But it is all gone, and it is very mild. upper 40s. Temperatures won't be falling anymore for the rest of the night. Very warm storm system that's tracking off to our west, so severe storms across the Midwest. We'll be tracking some of that rain into New England as we head towards tomorrow. Bunches of severe weather here across parts of Missouri, Illinois, into Indiana, and Michigan. Notice the lack of snowfall, very warm systems here. We'll be tracking that rain to Michigan right now, arriving here late tomorrow morning. There could be a couple of scattered showers early tomorrow morning, but I think there'll be more isolated than anything else. A lot of clouds out the door. Best chance of rain tomorrow about 10 a.m. to 2 o'clock. This is where I think we'll see some downpours and locally heavy rain. Could have some thunder, even some damaging wind gusts as those blow through right around midday. Then we should get a lull, and there could be another round of storms after sunset, heading into the late evening, even the overnight. This last line you see approaching after midnight is the actual cold front. All being bringing the cooler air eventually. In terms of that severe weather threat, it is much of the east tomorrow. If we were to see maybe an isolated tornado spin up, there are conditions that are very similar to what we saw on Saturday, and they could be across western Connecticut or western Massachusetts. We'll keep a close eye on things here on the eastern end of the state. So damaging wind gusts would be our main threat, and there is that low but still there risk of an isolated tornado tomorrow. So stay weather aware. We'll be tracking weather temperatures that will climb up into the 60s during the afternoon. It'll actually feel pretty muggy outside during the second half of the day. And it won't take much to break our record for tomorrow. Record of 63 in Boston, 63 in Worcester. We are forecasting both of those records to fall. And then a huge change. After all this warm air, we start to cool down on Thursday on gusty winds, much chillier on Friday in the mid-30s. We might even see some light snow. And then the brunt of the cold is here on Saturday. And we've all changed our routines. We're all thinking it's spring now. It's not really spring. And it's going to feel very much like winter. High temps maybe staying in 20 to around 30 for upcoming Saturday. Overnight lows will be back in the single digits. So here's the 7-day outlook. The cold is basically here Friday through Sunday morning. By Sunday afternoon, we're back towards 40. We're into the 40s on Monday, and we're back to 50 by Tuesday. David, Lisa, back to you. Well, Eric, thank you so much. It is trading time.
But do the Bruins mean anything? Dan Rice and the Red Hot Bees coming up next.
WBZ and American Alarm have a clue for you. While developing a gas sensor, a Swiss physicist lit a cigarette and accidentally invented the first one of these safety devices. Speaking.
For your home security, you could depend on a nosy neighbor or the 24-hour security command center with 20-second response from American Alarm. It's better than a nosy neighbor. American Alarm, New England's trusted security company.
The correct response? What is a smoke detector? Watch Jeopardy! This night at 7:30 on WBZ.
test drive a BMW today at your Massachusetts BMW Center or visit us at BMWMass.com.
Well, the Red Hot Bruins welcome the lowly Arizona Coyotes to town tonight. The final game before tomorrow afternoon's trade deadline at 3 o'clock. And the Bruins got on the board early in this one, just 3:06 into the first period when David Hodgson finds Colin Miller for the wrist turn. This trip to the air, 1-0 Bruins. Moved out of the second with tied at 1 when Miller drills Coyote center Alexander Vermeestroff with a scorching open ice hit, and Vermeestroff isn't getting up. Watch the hit again. It appears to be clean, but Miller was ejected for it. Even worse, Vermeestroff had to be carried off on a stretcher. Thankfully, he would give the thumbs up sign as he was leaving the ice, and after undergoing tests at the hospital, he was released and rejoined the team. He should be fine. But the Coyote is going to power play, but it's the Bees that go for the short-handed goal. Creed Bergeron with the missing steal and Steve Diley match with a short-handed goal. 2-1 Bruins. They go on to win a 4-1 to improve to 7-1 under Bruce Cassidy. Pretty good stuff. All right. Meanwhile, for the Patriots, Dante Hightower is one of the key pillars of the team's defense. His sack of Matt Ryan during the Super Bowl was a game changer. However, that could be the last big play of his Patriots career. ESPN's Adam Schefter reported the Pats will not use the franchise tag on Hightower, meaning the five-year vet is set to become a free agent. That doesn't mean he won't be back. He could still work out a new deal, but starting March 7th, he's free to speak to other teams. Teams are allowed to use the franchise tag once a year, automatically giving a player a one-year contract worth the top five, the average of the top five players in his position. Currently, that figure is just south of $15 million. In other NFL news, the Jets have released old friend Darrell Revis. The quarterback is coming off a disappointing second stint with the Jets. He was also charged with four felonies earlier this month for his role in a street fight in Pittsburgh. The four Myers would go spring training action between the Red Sox and Yankees. Bottom step was 2-0 in New York. When Pablo Sandoval cranks the double to deep left center, Jackie Bradley Jr. scores all the way from first, and it's a 2-1 game. Bottom of the sixth, now 3-2 Bombers, and Sam Savage drives a solo home run over everything to the left. His first is spring. That ties the game at 3, and the Yankees go on to win it by a score of 5-4. Basketball, Andrew Bogut is not coming to Boston. Instead, the free agent center is headed to Cleveland to play with LeBron James and the defending world champion Cavaliers. The Celtics, one of a handful of teams Bogut was reportedly interested in joining. No word on if they'll be in uniform tomorrow night. The Cavs are with the guard to take on the Celtics. We have the night off. Here's Malika.
Sam, thanks. Getting back in the game.
That's 11. The Patriots star is teaming up with the local aquarium to see this field. We'll be back.
Missed an episode of your favorite CBS show?
Well, that's not good.
Catch up now before the new season begins with CBS All Access. Watch full seasons of CBS shows at home or on the go. I did not see that coming. Go to cbs.com/allaccess now to try it free.
This is actually true. This is all sample has the hardest field wounded in the waters off New York return to the ocean. Defense event take wild posed for a selfie with the field, aptly named Trey, in Charlestown, Rhode Island today. Then flowers open the pet carrier door and look at this little guy. This is called Trey a girl earlier, but through the field, through his namesake, quick release off the line, hit the water, look backwards, I'm okay, everybody.
I hope that the seal had that, you know, that little app on its phone where it tracks the shark.
I do not want to see this with it.
I'd have to take one more look at the forecast.
And there's a lot to be looking at.